Welcome to Sakura Zoo, Conservation Canada's newest franchise zoo, which is set in the heart of Japan. Today, we start with the Binturong Habitat. My name is Gunther, and thanks for joining us on this new project. If you want to see more of Sakura Zoo or show your support for the channel, make sure to subscribe and leave a like. All right, we are back in franchise mode, which I'm really excited for. There's a lot of different nuances with building in franchise mode. The joys of having to balance your budget, make sure you're managing correctly is really fun for me. I love this management aspect of the game, so expect to see some of these pop up throughout the videos as we start managing a new working zoo. Now, if you've come off of Iguazu onto Sakura Zoo, welcome to a new zoo project, and expect to see a lot more of Sakura Zoo, more so because I'm really excited about building this. It's a whole new style for me. Now, speaking of style, expect to see a lot of plaster style buildings. You already saw me do some of the framework, and for today, I'm really focusing on the planning aspect of creating this habitat. We are on a finite budget. We have $40,000 to work with, which in the grand scheme of things is not a lot when you're trying to create something that's going to be as realistic as possible at this stage in my experience with Planet Zoo. So on that note, you're gonna see, as mentioned, a lot of plaster buildings, a lot of black on white or white on black, just because it pops and it kind of screams that Japanese more modern style architecture. The inspiration for this build and for the entrance in particular is coming from Ueno Zoo in Japan. I'm really excited about this. A lot of the photos I've seen have been super crisp and super clean, and I'm trying to take that over into our new zoo. Our Binturong habitat is starting to take shape. Right now it's broken up into two sections. We're going to have an indoor den area, as well as this really basic looking exterior. Right now, I get it, it's a box. There's nothing too fancy about it. But in order to make this pop a little bit more and look a little bit more inviting, we're focusing on creating one iconic structure. And for our Binturongs, it's going to be this rock pile. Definitely worked its way up, which is also why we're going to add some mesh to the top of our habitat. We do not want to have any of our Binturongs going out and exploring into Sakura Zoo. Now, with our habitat shape confirmed, it's all about adding in some foliage. And for me, we're working with a new foliage palette. For this particular build, we're going to see a beech sapling, some alpine currant, blackthorn bramble bushes, hawthorn bushes, common saltwort, wild hedgerows, which is always a nice thing to add in. We're also going to add in a lot of buffalo grass. And I realize buffalo grass is not native to Asia. I totally take ownership for that particular one, but I love the way it looks. Now, I realize there is actually a grass piece that is available in Asia. I totally didn't realize that there was one there. And maybe we'll see that one take more of center stage in our particular build. The last item that I've added into this particular build is actually going to be a Planet Zoo log. You've seen me utilize these logs quite a few times, and I really love how it looks. It adds a lot of natural detritus to the floor, and it looks very natural. This also acts as a place for our Binturongs to come and hang out, which is center stage for our guests to take a peek. With our foliage complete, it is time for us to focus on some more of the needs of the Binturong, and one of those core needs is going to be some climbable structures, and we have the perfect place to add these structures into, which is our really large rock pile. I realize on its own it looked fantastic, but sadly it just doesn't have a lot of navigatable area for our Binturongs, so adding these climbing structures helps to extend it out, provide a little bit of a different egress for them to utilize, and we can work it into the actual den of our habitat itself as well. So there's a few ways that we're going to make this all really work together to create one cohesive looking, fun looking habitat build. I do have a few disclaimers to share. The first one is we are building with free build. Free build definitely changes a lot of the capabilities of the game and natural pieces. So if you're seeing me utilize pieces in ways that maybe you can't, it's because of free build. I also have a second mod installed called PZ Plus. This is an interesting mod, and really it changes a few core aspects of the game. Right off the bat, the total size requirements for habitats is modified. Part of the reason that Planet Zoo has such large habitat sizes, it's to offset the hitboxes for particular animals. So PZ Plus also changes hitboxes. This is what's allowing me to create this Binturong habitat that maybe appears to be a little bit smaller than normal, but also has a lot of different details worked into it. As I've been getting better with Planet Zoo, I've been wanting to build more realistic habitats, and it's the use of these two mods that allows me to build habitats that I think are a little bit more realistic for me. Now, our habitat is nearing completion. The exterior is almost completed, and there's still quite a bit of work left to do on the building itself, but we are near the end of our journey from a foliage perspective. Our climbing structures are complete. It's really now about adding a few additional details, such as food bowls, water dishes, things like that. But I do want to share one tip when it comes to climbing structures. If you're like me, you want to create something that's going to look really cool, but you hate it when your animals turn into a temporary ghost and phase through the center of your climbing structures. Part of the reason why is because you might have forgotten to turn off the climbable feature on some of your support beams. So make sure you go back and turn those off. You are probably going to have to adjust a few minor details, but that being said, it's definitely worth the payoff. With all of the foliage, rock work, and climbing structures complete, it is time for us to focus on our guest barrier. The idea of a double barrier for your habitats is actually quite sound. You do not want guests to stick any fingers or hands or any tools or any garbage through those mesh walls, so adding a little bit of additional barrier with the second guest barrier actually works really well. Now, this is not my design. This actually is inspired by Blob. He had this amazing glass barrier that he put together, and I'm just utilizing that as inspiration. So thank you, Blob, for this amazing idea, and you can kind of see it taking shape. Now, there's nothing too fancy about this overall build. We're utilizing some poles as our support structures, some key beams for the top and the bottom, some glass, and then the last piece is going to be this bracket. And this bracket acts as the clamp that's going to hold all of our glass in place. Again, thank you to Blob for this amazing idea. We're finally on to the last step of our overall build. And this really comes back to our support building. This is quite a large support building. It's probably one of the tallest I've ever built in Planet Zoo. And the reality is the second floor is going to be entirely inaccessible. It's really just there for appearances. Now, I will say this clay tile roof looks absolutely stunning when you start to mix it all together with the white. It really begins to pop with that black on white that I was mentioning earlier. Okay. I had mentioned that I wanted to focus on creating a realistic habitat for our binturongs. So while we start working on the exterior of the building, really kind of want to talk about some of the thought process that went into that. Right off the bat, the binturong is known as the bear cat. And really, despite the nickname, they're neither bear nor cat. They're called that though because they have the ears of a bear and the tail of a cat. Now, speaking of that tail, it's actually a prehensile tail. And really just what that means is they have a little bit more control over it. They actually utilize this to wander through trees and across branches. So this just allows them to be a little bit more stable. So knowing that, creating some climbing structures that use the smaller climbing poles kind of feeds the idea that they might actually use their tail to navigate or maybe hang around a little bit. So it's these small details that really kind of make the habitat a little bit more realistic. On top of that, they weirdly smell like buttered popcorn. Now they utilize this scent to mark their territory. But in our zoo, we're going to utilize it to feel about that tactile learning experience. So for me, I want our guests to be able to see, smell, and hear all about these animals. Being able to smell buttered popcorn through the mesh walls is a unique feature that I really want to highlight with our guests. Now, it's all of these realistic aspects that go into making a habitat that's a little bit more realistic. Now, it's not going to be perfect, don't get me wrong, but it's all about a learning experience and a journey. Now, there is one thing that I've neglected to share, and it's the name of our two binturongs. So we have one male and one female, and this is really where I want to focus on the community. So the idea is in the comments below, you'll put your recommendation for a male and a female name for a binturong. And then on Thursday, during our regular channel update, we'll just share a quick update letting you guys know what the names are of our binturongs as decided by you. And that's really cool. I'm all about community when it comes to Planet Zoo. So keep an eye out for a quick Thursday update and look forward to seeing your touch on Sakura Zoo. Now, our exterior is definitely taking shape and there's really not much more left to do. We are looking at a lot of empty white space, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm a huge fan of having empty space sometimes. It looks really sleek and really modern, but we really wanna add a little bit of color, and here is a perfect example. We have an AC unit that's gonna be helping to cool our building. We wanna make sure that our binturongs are in a temperature secured location, but we also wanna add a little bit of power. So something really quick, just adding in some of these cable pieces, making sure they line up just perfectly with this switch, really helps to create something that's going to look really sleek and really modern. I love how this turned out. Making it pop a little bit with the black really has it stand out. You can't go wrong with adding this to your overall build. Now, the other thing I'm adding are these additional pipes. There is not a lot from water management on this building. You're not seeing any eaves troughs and stuff like that. So instead, we're going to add in these pipes. They're going to act as eaves troughs or more of a stand-in for them. Non-functional, but they look fantastic. And at the end of the day, sometimes that's all that matters. You just want to create something that's visually pleasing. We have a few final details that we have to work on, but ideally our zoo is taking shape. Our first habitat is almost complete and our guests are gonna be super happy. In fact, they are very happy with what we've put together. The last thing that I have to work on the exterior is just this little foliage area. This zoo is kind of inspired by a city zoo, when traditionally zoos are located in cities. So we don't have a lot of green space to work with. Everything is gonna be very compact or very well thought out and planned. So to that end, utilizing this small area to add some additional greenery goes a long way for transporting your guests from the city into your zoo. And on top of that, these stone plinths make this look fantastic. And just like that, we're on our final portion of the build, which is really just the interior. There's not much that's gonna go on in here. Really, we're just looking at creating a nice little den and backstage area for our staff to work in, as well as our binturongs to come and take a break. It's super important that we have areas off exhibit for our binturongs to hide, but also for our staff to work with them. So to that end, creating an implied backstage area that our staff or maybe our vets would access if they needed to assist with feeding, anything like that, is a fantastic way to add a little bit of additional realism to your overall build. Now, the sad part about building backstage areas is that you don't really ever explore them, and that's the unfortunate part. But I'm gonna make this work a little bit differently. And how I'm gonna do that is I'm gonna add in some additional climbing structures. Now, there's a few ways that you can add in your climbing structures to your zoo. I liked building them into the wall. I thought it was a really cool way of creating something that was gonna look a little bit more realistic, but it also uses up all of that blank space. Again, I like blank spaces, but sometimes you don't want them, and this is a perfect example of that. On top of that, part of me hopes that we'll eventually one day see our binturongs maybe exploring the second level in their backstage den. If it's really terrible weather outside, if it's too cold or too warm for them, we want to provide an area where they can come in and explore off exhibit, but still meet the requirements of their habitat, which in this case, lots of climbing space. The last thing that I'm going to add on this video is just going to be our prep area. This is where our staff can come and prepare food, make sure that medication is ready to go, maybe assist with some training as well. So it's super important that we want to create an area that's going to look a little bit lived in and maybe not so clean this time. The exterior of our zoo, where all of our guests are, we really want that to be a very clean and very thought-provoking area. The interior, though, we have a little bit more that we can work with. Now, as we're doing this, I realize the walls are white. They look kind of weird, and I agree with you. So stay tuned. We are going to fix that at the very end. Now, feedback is always important when it comes to playing Planet Zoo. You can improve significantly, but sometimes all it takes is a little bit of extra work. So to that end, I have a few requests. Number one, let me know what your favorite part of this build was. For me, it's definitely gotta be this building. I absolutely love how this building looked, but I would love to hear what you guys like the most as well. Number two, I also wanna hear what you think I could have improved on and changed. Part of improving within Planet Zoo is just getting critical feedback. And that's what I really want from you guys. Let me know where I could have improved to make something even bigger or even better, and that'll help me to improve. And I really appreciate that. And lastly, if you haven't done so, hit the subscribe button if you want to see more Sakura Zoo. I'm really excited to see how this zoo goes. I've waited so long to build this particular style of zoo, and I think my skills are there that I can do this justice, but I'm going to need your help along the way. And lastly, think about hitting that like button. You hitting the like button really helps this episode to grow and this channel to grow, and I would really appreciate it. But I want you to remember, and as always, there's no pressure to do so. So don't feel that you need to do that. Just do it if you want to do it, and I would appreciate that regardless. Now, if you remember, I mentioned this white wall did not look really cool, and I agree. So I changed to this burnt orange painted brick, and I gotta say, this really makes this habitat come together. It brightens everything up, and that's really the key to creating this final binturong habitat. And just like that, we are at the end of the episode. I'm gonna leave you here with some cinematic shots of all of our guests looking in on our binturongs, and I just wanna say thank you for your support and watching this episode. And as always, ciao for now.